Mr. Prime Minister, Mr. Defense Minister, General, allow me to introduce myself. My name is François Rousseau. I'm in charge of an informal research group, which does not appear in your organization charts. Our president, to whom I personally and exclusively refer, thought it useful, if not necessary, that I clarify for you a certain number of issues. You think that as initiates you're better informed than most people. Allow me to doubt it. At this very moment, things are taking place. They are somehow serious enough for the informations and documents that I kept for you be revealed to you now. In a word, a manipulative operation unparalleled to this day on a planetary scale is being implemented and will be the final subject of my talk. As regards our era, everything in reality started just before World War II. Hitler had broken certain taboos, such as taking recourse to occultism and secret societies. The Annenerbe, a Nazi organization assigned with, among other things, archaeological and anthropological research, found this during an expedition to Afghanistan. This flying object is called Vimana, or Astra, by the Hindus. Moreover, during exploration of the subsoil by the Russians and Chinese in 1927, traces of a very ancient nuclear explosion were detected. Certain sedimentary layers had been atomically vitrified 50,000 years ago. The very same phenomenon can be observed around today's nuclear test sites. One must understand that Hitler, thanks to these discoveries which he took highly seriously, was going to open a Pandora's box which no government, whether friend or enemy, wished to close afterward. Behind tragic history, which we all know, lies a theory based on the existence of four moons associated with a four geological cycle. According to Hans Urbiger, founder of the world ice theory, the Earth had undergone four semi-global extinctions of life due to the fall of one of these moons. Effectively, as one goes along, the satellite moved closer, gravity changed and triggered some deep mutation of the genetic standard, thereby creating a race of highly intelligent giants measuring approximately between 10 to 13 feet tall. Several tens of thousand years later, the moon crashed, the impact causing a serious rise in sea levels and a nuclear-like global winter. This race of giants was to disappear due to a terrestrial gravity which had grown too powerful and incapacitating for their unusual size. Hitler was initiated to these doctrines, and contacts with Tibet in particular were frequent. The Nazis sought contact with the survivors of ancient civilizations, holders of ancient technologies like the previously described Vimanas. One of these civilizations spread out over the entire planet more than 600 pyramids made of stone, earth, and even iron. These pyramids are almost all pointed in the same direction, all have the same proportion as number pi, and all situated in magnetotelluric nodes. The oldest are in Asia. Two of them are submerged, one south of Japan at Okinawa, another south of Cuba. These two were built about 12,000 years ago. I began by this small archaeological reminder for this reason. Our civilization is the fourth of the cycle which I described previously. Yes, I know that might well hurt our pride. We're neither the first nor the last. One must understand that the study and understanding of several recovered prototypes were the absolute priority to ensure Nazis' domination over the skies. The Allies, in parallel, focused on mastering atom and creating the first nuclear bombs. These secret bases were the center of all research supervised by the Nazis. In one of these bases worked Victor Schauberger, father of the Nazis' UFOs. Schauberger headed the Vril Society in charge of anti-gravitational research. He died in 1958 in Texas while working under protection of the United States on the improvement of his own flying saucers, which have since become American. You will quickly understand that 70% of unexplained aerial phenomena are human in origin and in no way extraterrestrial. Once World War II was over and Nazi technology had been systematically plundered by both Americans and Russians, the first challenge was to carry on and even complete the Nazis' research in great secrecy. The program called Project Rainbow, especially known for the Philadelphia experiment, was the immediate proof. Mathematician von Neumann, who collaborated with Albert Einstein and Nikola Tesla on behalf of the Navy, succeeded in accidentally teleporting a cannon-class destroyer escort, the USS Eldridge. These photos, supplied by Morris K. Jessup before his suspicious death, are rare testimonies for this unique experiment. In the same time, the first Indo-Aryan technology prototype trials did not go by unnoticed. The military had come up with a more efficient parade than secrecy. At about the same period, Kenneth Arnold, U.S. Air Force pilot and CIA agent, launched the greatest operation in manipulation ever concerning the existence of UFOs. Making people believe they didn't exist was not the right solution and clearly insufficient. Discrediting enemies and frightening the population by systematic misinformation proved far more efficient. UFOs and parahuman belong henceforth to the movies, television, and collective paranoia, and not to the realm of scientists, as it should have been the case. In May 1947, the American Secret Services discovered the existence of an ancient terrestrial UFO secretly recovered by the Russians, which had crashed into the Altai Mountains along their border with Mongolia. Tension between the two blocs immediately rose a serious notch. The discovery was spectacular, and so not to lose face, the Pentagon, in tandem with the CIA, decided to tell lies and imagined a huge bluff to convince both the Russians and the world at large that they too recovered a UFO in Roswell in July 1947. Of course, it wasn't true, but the bluff worked all the same. In February 1949, just after the so-called Roswell incident, a UFO was photographed and filmed in Antarctica. It was the first photo of this type of a cigar-shaped object. Other appearances were then to follow in one another by cyclic waves. At the same moment, the Apollo program, headed by Wernher von Braun, was in full swing, and Dr. Braun in no way favorably welcomed the demand for paranormal experiments, which nevertheless took place during certain Apollo missions. This is the last known experiment on psychic and telepathic amplification as well as detection of psitron particles emitted by the Yogi towards the Apollo capsule. But these tests were all eclipsed by the systematic appearance of unidentified objects around orbital flights and the discovery of traces of civilization on the moon. NASA had to face an avalanche of data and embarrassing proofs. The only solution was to put everything under the cloak of defense secret. In 1971, the Jason Directive set up a special retouching service whose purpose was to erase all signs of civilizations or ruins on the moon, especially in those photos intended for the general public and the press. In June 1965, has appeared this in a satellite report in the area of Deception Islands, south of Argentina. The Russians tried to sabotage the refloating operation in vain, despite the violence of the confrontation.